Hello everyone and welcome to the OSU PH Nationals. I am Lazerid and I am here with Muk Jay-Z. Hello, Muk Jay-Z. Anyways, we will be featuring two players from that will be facing each other in this tournament. It'll be Gleo and Sachiani. Both players are pretty good rice players, I have to say. And we are already going with the warm-up. This is, well, the Among Us trap remix. So already coming in with a meme warm-up. Yeah, a lot. And
hello, hello.
Yeah. Hello.
Hi now. There we go.
There we go. So yeah, both players, from what I can see, their best skill set seems to be rice. What do you think?
I think so too. They have like really similar skill sets from what I've seen in their past matches.
Yes. So starting off, yes, we already have a meme warm-up, but this does kind of reflect on the accuracies. Oh, Gleo with the drop there. But you can see that Gleo's accuracy is pretty good. This might reflect into the match.
Maybe in this particular match, it's just all about whoever can keep their ACK up, you know?
Ooh. And we are... The next warm-up will be Lumpiang Shanghai Deluxe.
Maybe this is another meme. This is another meme one.
It might actually be legit because, like, this song is made for like BMS, I think. So.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, interesting.
Can you get me a spring roll? Meaty, full of flavor.
Yeah. Yum. So we're gonna be waiting for both players to be ready. It's a 5-star warm-up and it's made by Arcad, or mapped by Arcad. So we can expect maybe some jacks or something from what they can hear from the song. Oh, and there you can see the Arcad in the background in the in the sauce. Oh, this is speed. So that's a burst. Ooh.
Can you get me a spring roll? Meaty, full of flavor.
Yeah, this mini jacks over here. Holy moly. Both of their accuracies are very close, though.
Seems like this skill set is like their accuracies are similar.
Yeah, both. Yeah, they seem to be really good at jacks. If they weren't facing each other, then they might pick like a jack map to take advantage of that.
That was
Tachiani missing in that. This map is pretty unforgiving.
Yeah.
But yeah, Gleo with a 98 in this, pretty impressive. Yeah, these bursts are not stopping them. Oh, and Cleo with the, Sachiani with a miss as well. Kind of a weird one. They were like, you know, having fun in that long LN. cool. Yeah, both players showing their proficiency in core jacks. They're pretty good. Now this map is making me crave for some Lumpiang Shanghai, to be honest. Looking at the background of it.
That Lumpiang Shanghai with Arcat and the sauce.
Yeah, they look kind of delicious, to be honest.
Yeah.
Whoa, 5 200s. Wow. It's just that he had so many misses. It's pretty impressive.
Yeah, still, it's really good considering that, you know.
Yeah. It's just that he dropped so much misses. But anyways, we'll be coming to the roles and seeing whoever wins and, well, loses. Ooh, Gleo with the 86 and Sachiani with the 70. Both rolls are pretty high. Unfortunately, Gleo has a way higher roll than him. Gleo protects Ka, the tech map.
That's Rice 4, right?
Yes.
I'm not mistaken.
Tachiani protecting Hybrid 1. Both protects are very, very good for their skill sets because, like, Gleo isn't known to be the best LN or Hybrid player. So, he's trying to cover up that weakness of his. And Tachiani bans the speed map, Dash Hopes, which makes sense because Gleo seems to be the faster player out of the both. And we're going to be seeing whatever map Gleo will ban and LN to, which is to be expected. Gleo is not really good at LN, at least according to the qualifiers. So, and we're going to be seeing Gleo's pick after this. So what do you think, Machesi, what do you think Gleo would pick in this match?
I think maybe one of the Rices.
Yeah,
as I say that, he just picked Rice 1.
Yeah, good bounce. That seems to be the more ackable Rice 1, the Rice map. Yeah. Looking at the warm-ups, Gleo seems to be the more accurate one. The player out of the both of them with the stronger ratio. So it will be... we will see if Tachiani will be able to overcome that challenge.
Well, maybe in that case, maybe Tachiani should hope that Gleo would mess up a bit.
Oh yeah, that's true.
Then have a chance at least for Rice.
Yeah. So the MP start already going on. Gleo versus Tachiani. Who would you win in this match? Who would win this match?
Honestly, it can go to either side. They're like we said earlier, like they're really good.
Yeah, they're both really good. Tachiani with the ratio lead. Pretty good. But I mean, Gleo, yeah. Tachiani, 99.7 is still really good, honestly.
It's just that Gleo is just keeping his accuracy really high,
yeah.
Maintaining it.
Gleo is dropping to the 99.87. But Tachiani managed to reach the 99.80. Ooh, this is actually close.
They're actually improving it. Maybe Tachiani does have a chance.
Yeah, yeah. This is really close. Both of them having a 0.05 lead, accuracy lead. Ooh, Tachiani dropping a little bit, but it's still really close. Yeah, halfway through the map with these chords. Some people may mess up on these chords over here. Achiani dropping a little bit, but it's still 0.1% difference, accuracy difference.
Leo still keeping his 99.86% back.
Yeah, he's still consistent.
That's insane.
Yeah. Yeah, we have these. Oh. No one dropping on these cards. This is just pure ratio battle. Oh, Satchiani increasing his ACK right now. This ending is going to be to see if whoever takes this point is.
Ooh, oh, both players dropped!
They both missed. Oh.
Oh my god!
It might still be. Oh.
What the heck was that?
That's a really close score between the two.
Yo. Oh, Gleo with a 1-200, but what the heck? That's so close.
That ratio is insane for Gleo right there.
Gleo, way beyond the 1-10 ratio, that's for sure. The magic 1-10 ratio, but it's still. But despite the miss, Gleo still gets the point. First point of the match.
Now I think it's Tachiani's turn, right?
Yep, it's his turn to pick. And he picks Masquerade.
Ooh, LN1.
Yeah, probably the last LN map, apart from the hybrid. Yeah, this is a release-heavy map. So, if you don't know much about releases, it will. If you're not proficient in LN releases, then you will drop a lot of accuracy. And possibly even lose combo. Both players, they don't seem to be great at LNs. So let's see how they will perform in this LN map. Satchiani with ACK drops in the beginning. Gleo with the ACK. Oh, Gleo missed, as
Gleo
I was about to
drops
say.
There. Now Satchiani has the slight lead right now.
Yeah. Satchiani and has the ACK and the combo advantage right now. Although it's the beginning of the map, Gleo will have a disadvantage, a combo disadvantage, because Satchiani reached the combo cap first. Ooh, Satchiani! Let's go!
That breaks. Yeah.
Both players now have equal accuracies, but Satchiani will lose that lead because of the combo. The thing about missing in this map is that there's not much combo to be built from here. It's really slow. Satchiani managing to take that lead even with that miss, but it's a tiny, tiny lead. Any ACK drops here would ruin Satchiani's lead right now. Ooh. Gleo dropped some accuracy, I guess, judging from the lead. Satchiani managing to hold that 99.53, while Gleo has a 99.31.
We're already at around like the last parts of the map, so I don't think there's much of a chance for Gleo to catch up.
There is a lot of chances. This last part of the map is capable of making both of these players chokes, and we see Gleo missing.
Gleo, I think that seals the deal now.
Yes, unless if Satchiani misses so hard, it's really hard to see Gleo taking this point. And that should do it. Satchiani, first point on the board. Satchiani has superior ratio and 200 count. He just had that one miss.
Now Gleo picking Rice 3.
Yep, to be expected from Gleo. He has to keep taking that rise advantage. This is the last LN map, and Sachiani has no choice but to pick the hybrid map. Unless if Sachiani can play the SP map. Which, actually, no, it would be really hard for Sachiani to play the SV maps, because Gleo seems to be proficient in the SV map, so it'd be really hard. This is a risky position for Sachiani to be in. And the MP start is here. You will see both players playing immediately after Gleo clicks this map. We'll see whoever wins this. Both players in the beginning having equal accuracy, but Sachiani dropping. Probably from the ratio. Yeah, it'll be. Yeah, this map has patterns that change pretty quickly. So while the BPM is pretty consistent, the patterns change pretty quickly. And if you're not ready, you will get a nasty accuracy drop or even a miss.
Yeah, so far, Gleo is just keeping his app really well.
Yeah, Gleo with a 99.8 now. Sachiani with a 99.49.
Sachiani slowly building it up.
Yeah.
But I don't think that would be enough now.
Yeah, this map is really short. 1 minute and 17 seconds is not a lot of time.
Yeah.
Gleo, unless if he misses, would take this point with a 993.
Impressive score. Actually, yeah. A double S.
Yep, V1 double S from Gleo. Sachiani with 214 300s, but with 5 200s. Now, Sachiani would have to pick map, probably hybrid, if I'm gonna think about it. But we'll see. Sachiani picks SV. Ooh, this is not something I expected from him.
Did you just say that Gleo is more proficient in SV compared to Sachiani?
Yes. Gleo is 9th place in the qualifiers in SV.
This is an interesting pick then.
Yep.
I wonder.
Really? This is a risky pick for Sachiani, but I'm thinking that Sachiani is saving that hybrid as a closing pick. But this is a risky pick because if Gleo wins this, then Gleo would pick and it's match point for him, so... See, it's either Sachiani is not very confident on the hybrids, or he thinks that he can beat Gleo in this SV map, but we'll see. We'll see. At the start of the map, Gleo showcasing his superior ratio ability, as seen in the rest of the match. Sachiani, though, not too far behind, but he dropped some 200s.
Although Gleo drops a bit as well.
Yeah, this is really close. Scores are flickering, but it's clearly in Gleo's lead because of the accuracy. Any drops in this SV map is fatal because of how short it is, 2 minutes and 23 seconds. Galeo's still holding on to that 99.7. That is pretty good. We're halfway to the chart, and Galeo has to drop some accuracies here. Of course, this middle part is the break part, so it's really hard to see that. But the next part, the next SV part of the map, we'll see if both of these players manage to maintain that accuracy and combo. And here it comes. Leo almost reaching to the 99.8. Satriani reaching the 99.6, but it's not gonna be enough unless if Galeo messes up big time in these SVs, then it'll be Galeo's point with a 99.81. That's pretty good. 1-200.
Yeah.
With almost 1-10 ratio. That's pretty good.
Impressive score.
Yep. Satriani with 2-200. Also really good score, but. Galeo just has the superior accuracy and ratio. It's Galeo's match point and his pick.
I'm gonna guess it's probably Rice 4 just to end the match.
Yes, he's probably gonna have to end it with the tech map. Yep, it's his protect. This map is really going to challenge players' tech ability. Unfortunately for Satriani, he doesn't have any more LN picks left because of the amount of LN maps in here. So he was forced to pick SV, I guess. And while we wait, the MP start link is actually here already, so I don't think we need to wait anymore. But this is potentially the last map pick. Galeo match point. This pick. Ha. Let's see.
So far, Galeo has the accuracy.
Satriani dropping. So
98
much
now.
He's
improving it though.
Achion. Yeah. Galeo with a 99.85. That's pretty good. Yeah, this map is really short, so any app drops and misses would be detrimental. Satriani with a 99.3. Play with the maintaining that 99.85. Yeah, we're in the halfway mark and these streams, trills and everything, these race notes. They don't seem to be messing up both of these players' combo, but Galeo with the superior accuracy. Satriani managed to increase his ACK to 99.59. Pretty big improvement compared to what he started with, but it doesn't mean it's enough.
It might not be enough. It's already the last quarter.
We're reaching the last quarter and Galeo has is almost reaching the 99.90, which is really impressive. At this point, this is way is at this point it's above 1-10 ratio. Ooh, this map, as it's coming to a close, unless if Gleo messes up in these final bursts, it doesn't seem to happen. Gleo winning this match 4-1
with the 995k score.
That is an impressive ratio.
1-1.
Tachiani with one miss. I didn't realize that. Holy moly. Both players did really well. Tachiani, if it wasn't for Gleo, then he would have actually passed through group stage, but unfortunately, he had to face against Gleo.
True. But still, they did really well this match.
Yeah, they did really well. Both players, they did their best. And congratulations to Gleo for winning this group stage match. And as it's tradition, we have to mention the uncensored profile picture. So yeah. Congratulations to Gleo. Next match. So next match, which will happen in 1 minute and around 30 seconds, it'll be another 4-key match between Baitan Robot and Ola. What do you think?
Wait a minute. Did I just hear the stream right? You say 1 minute and 30 seconds?
Oh, 1 hour, sorry. Sorry about that. We already got scuffed in the end. It's always the ending that makes me get scuffed. Sorry about that. It was a quick
match. Carry on.
Yeah, so next match, it'll be between Betan Robot and Olaf, which would be a 4-key match. Both players are pretty good, so I would stick around.
It's also the final 4-key match of the group stage, so...
Yep. This is the last 4-key match, so there'll be between pretty good players and also a few changes, so I guess, yep. A few changes in the commentary booth, of course. And I hope everyone had a good day. Congratulations to Gleo. Good game to both players. And I hope you had a wonderful, wonderful day.